Hello everyone, in this video we will see the serial communication interface. So serial communication, so many of the input and output devices transfer information to the computer or from the computer serially one bit at a time. Whenever it is transmitting or receiving bits one by one, then it is called as a serial communication. So several serial interface devices are present and they will have status register to indicate the status of the current communication, and control register to control the serial communication operation, and the data register to send and receive the data. So we see the block diagram for a simple serial communication interface. So this is the serial communication interface, which contains a status register, control register, and for receiving the serial input it will have data in shift register, which will be stored in a data in buffer register. Similarly, for transmitting it will have a data out buffer register, which will be sent serially out through the serial output line. So apart from that, it will have other interface logic circuits to interface with the different processor. So when you see the types of serial communication, so the communication could be simplex, meaning it is always one-way communication from one node to the other node. The next is called as duplex communication, which is two-way communication. So if there are two nodes, communication can happen from node A to node B or from node B to node A. When it is half duplex, even though it is two-way communication, only one-way communication can happen at a time. If there is one transmitter, if there are two nodes, node A and node B, at a time data transfer can happen from one node to the other node. When it is full duplex, both the nodes can send and receive at the same time. So two-way communication happens at the same time. Then when you see the types of serial communication, it could be asynchronous, meaning special bit pattern separate the characters. We'll see what it is. Okay, and synchronous communication, in which special sync characters are present at the beginning and idle characters are used to fill when there are no information available. So first we will see the asynchronous communication. So since there is no common clock, what happens is a signal transition from 1 to 0 indicates a beginning of a new character. So first there is a start bit, which is called as a mark. So transition from 1 to 0 indicates the start of a transmission. Then we have a character which is sent, which might occupy 5 to 8 bit in length. Then it might have an optional parity bit. Then there is a stop bit, and the stop bits could be 1, 1.5 or 2 bits duration. And after that there might be some dead space between characters, and again a 1 to 0 indicates a transmission of a new character. This is how the asynchronous communication happens. Whereas in the case of synchronous communication, a character contains 5 to 8 bits followed by optionally a parity bit. But in synchronous communication, there are no start bits, no stop bits. Instead, all transmissions start with a series of sync characters. So these characters are already decided between the transmitter and the receiver. So whenever the sync characters are received, it indicates start of transmission. So the receiver must know the identity of the sync character. When a sequence of bit arrives and if it matches with the sync character, it assumes that the transmission has begun. Okay. So now we will see 8251A programmable communication interface. So it is a USART, universal synchronous asynchronous receiver transmitter. So it could be used in both the synchronous mode as well as in the asynchronous mode of communication, and it could act as both the receiver and the transmitter. So it is a USA from Intel. So it is capable of being programmed for synchronous or asynchronous, and the serial bit stream arriving on the received data pin is shifted to the receiver shift register and read by the CPU. When it is transmitting, the output data bits on the output data out buffer register are transferred to the transmit data pin. So the mode, it contains mode register, which could be synchronous or asynchronous, and the control register, which controls the operation. So if you see the block diagram for 8 to 5 only, it contains the data bus buffer, which is used for transmission as well as for reception. So transmit control pins and the receive control pins. Okay. So for transmission, it has got transmit buffer. For reception, it has got the receive buffer. And there are modem control pins and the read write control logic. So this side, it is interfaced with the microprocessor. This side with the other part, with the IO device. Okay. So if you see the block diagram, it contains mode register, sync character 1, sync character 2. These are the sync characters which are to be used for the synchronous communication, and it contains the control register. So serial input is received using this receiver shift register, and it is stored in the data in buffer register, which is to be read by the microprocessor. Similarly, when any data needs to be transmitted, it is written from the microprocessor to the data out buffer register, which is using this shift register, is sent in a serial out fashion to the serial output pin, into the transmit data pin. So these are the modem control pins, we'll see later. So the mode register, in the asynchronous mode communication mode, if you see these two bits B2 and B1 indicates the baud rate factor. So the clock frequency equal to baud rate factor into baud rate. So this pins determine the baud rate of the communication. So 00, whenever it is 00, it indicates synchronous mode. So otherwise 01 means factor is 1, 10 factor is 16, 11 factor is 64. Then these two bits represent the length of the data bits. As we have seen, the length of the data bits could be anything from 5 to 7. So these two bits determine the number of data bits. Then this indicates whether, as we said, optional parity, whether parity is enabled or not is determined by this. One indicates parity bit is present. So if parity is present, it indicates whether the parity is odd or even. Then the last thing is the number of stop bits. 00 is an invalid combination, whether one stop bit or one and a half stop bits or two stop bits are present in the asynchronous mode. Then if it is going to be synchronous mode, as you have seen earlier, 00 indicates it is a synchronous mode. Again, these indicate the length of the number of data bits, 5, 6, 7 or 8. Then whether parity is enabled or not. Then whether it is parity is odd or even. Then this indicates external synchronous detect. So 0 indicates sync detect is output, 1 indicates sync detect is input. So whenever it is 0, it indicates the 8251 itself detects the sync characters. So whenever it receives a sync character, this bit is set. So when this sync detect is used as an input, an external device is used to detect the sync characters. So whenever this external device detects a sync character, then this sync detect is used as an input, so that match is determined by an external device. Then the number of sync characters, whether it is a single character or two characters, is determined by this. So 0 indicates two characters, 1 indicates one character sync. Then the control register, so this bit indicates the transmitter is enabled. So this indicates data terminal ready to go low. Next, this indicates the receiver is enabled. So whether we want to enable reception or transmission. Okay. Then it causes the break by forcing the transmit data pin to go low. So this causes all three error bits in status to be clear. So we will see the status register later. So where it contains the three different types of errors. So this causes all the error bits to be cleared. RTS stands for request sent. So these are used for handshake signals, modem handshake. This indicates internal reset. And this bit indicates a enter hunt mode. So hunt mode is the mode in which we are using in synchronous mode, where we the 8251 is looking for the sync characters to identify the start of transmission. So this is the asynchronous mode of communication, wherein the receive data pin and transmit data pin is connected to asynchronous modem communication equipment. So here the DSR, DTR, CTS, RTS, all these pins are connected for modem handshake, and the receiver clock and the transmitter clock are given by a external baud rate generator. Since it is asynchronous, there is no common clock, so there is a baud rate generator given here. So in the case of synchronous modem connection, the clock is given by the synchronous modem itself, so there is no need for external baud rate generator. Okay. So this RS-232C is used for level conversion. So if it is going to be TTL logic, if the external modem is going to operate at RS-232 level at a higher voltage, this provides the voltage conversion between different logic levels. Okay. This indicates the status register. So these pins, transmit ready, RX ready, and TXE, all these things are similar to the pin functionality, and these are the three errors that you have seen. So if there is an error detected in parity, this bit is set, which is called as a parity error. Overrun error, when before completion of the first character, the next character has started to come. Then framing sequence error, when a stop bit is not detected. So this is sync detect pin that we have seen earlier. So whenever an sync character is detected, this will be set. So if it is, the sync detect can be set as input or output. So whenever it is an output, so the 8251 itself detects a sync character. If it is an input, external device detects a sync character, and when it detects, this bit will be set, indicating a sync character detection. So data set ready, it indicates it is one, it indicates data set is ready. So now we will get into the summary. We have seen what is serial communication and the different modes of serial communication, like the asynchronous and the synchronous communication, and we have seen the different blocks and the different registers for 8251A, USART, programmable communication interface, and its mode register, control register, and status register. Thank you.